In lesson 6.4, students see two glow sticks, one that's been warmed and the other that's been cooled, and the one that's been warmed glows much brighter than the other one. So the question is, why does that happen? Students know that there are reactants inside the glow sticks, so the question is, how does the temperature of the reactants affect the chemical reaction? The big science concepts covered are, in a chemical reaction, the atoms in the reactants come apart, rearrange, and rebond to make the products, and that adding energy or heating makes the reactants move faster, which makes more of them collide in a shorter amount of time and collide harder, increasing the rate of the reaction. So you should have a discussion with students about a glow stick, what makes it work, that there's two components on the inside, one that's in a glass vial and the other solution outside the glass vial. So when you bend it and crack it, what's happening is that two substances are mixing and a chemical reaction is occurring. So once students know that, they see that you've placed one glow stick in cold water and one in hot. And when you activate them, they can see that the one in cold water doesn't glow nearly as bright as the one in hot. The one in hot water glows much brighter. So the question is, why did this happen? They know that a chemical reaction took place, but why did the temperature matter? So you can have students investigate whether temperature affects a chemical reaction by using the same reactants they used in the last experiment. They did a reaction between calcium chloride and sodium bicarbonate. Well, you can do the same reaction again. They could make a solution of calcium chloride and sodium bicarbonate and another solution of calcium chloride and sodium bicarbonate. And one pair of solutions they put in cold water and the other pair they put in hot water. And then when they mix them, let's see. So the one that was in hot water reacts much, much faster. You get a lot more bubbling, a lot of precipitate. And the one over here that was in cold water eventually will react, but it takes a while. So the question for students is, what's going on? You can show them a simple animation that shows two reactants and they move slowly, hit each other, and just bounce off. But now if they move faster, there's a chance they hit with enough force that the atoms come apart and rearrange and rebond to make products. And you can show them that the analogy is with the reaction that they did, the calcium chloride and sodium bicarbonate. If these reactants hit each other hard enough, then they can form products. And these are the products. Students watch a video of a chemical where a wick is put in and some heat is added so that it'll react. The reacting substance creates enough heat to even keep itself reacting. So they describe that to sort of confirm this idea that you have to have what's called an activation energy. You need to introduce enough energy so that atoms will hit hard enough to rearrange and rebond to form products. And even that process can release energy and keep the process going, but that'll come later. If you're in an NGSS state, there's a performance expectation, MSPS 1.5, which says, develop and use a model to describe how the total number of atoms does not change in a chemical reaction and thus mass is conserved. Well, in this case, you can show students the atoms in the reactants and the atoms in the products and show that mass was conserved. They've seen that before, but this shows something a little different, that heat increases the rate of the reaction, that atoms have to have enough energy in order to react. If you look at the foundation boxes, that students develop a model to describe unobservable mechanisms. In this case, the unobservable mechanism was that substances react faster if they're heated. This idea that substances react chemically in characteristic ways and that atoms that make up the original substance are regrouped into different molecules, they see that, and that the total number of each type of atom is conserved. For cross-cutting concepts, matter is conserved because atoms are conserved in physical and chemical processes. In this case, students saw a chemical process. So thanks for watching, and good luck with the lesson.